desires known and from whom those secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I am risen and am still with thee. Alleluia. Thou hast laid thine hand upon me. Alleluia. Thy knowledge is too wonderful and excellent for me. Alleluia, alleluia.
O Lord, thou hast searched me out and known me. Thou knowest my down sitting and my uprising.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
I am risen and am still with thee. Alleluia. Thou hast laid thy hand upon me. Alleluia. Thy knowledge is too wonderful and excellent for me. Alleluia. Alleluia. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
God on
and opened unto us the gate of everlasting life. We humbly beseech thee, as by thy special grace preventing us, thou dost put into our minds good desires, so by thy continual help we may bring the same to good effect, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Ghost ever, one God, world without end.
Amen.
The epistle is written in the third chapter of St. Paul's epistle to the Colossians, beginning at the first verse. If ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. Set your affection on things above, not on things on the earth. For ye are dead, and your life is hid with Christ in God. When Christ, who is our life, shall appear, then shall ye also appear with him in glory. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks be to God.
This is the day which the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is gracious, and his mercy endureth forever.
Alleluia, alleluia, Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Alleluia, alleluia.
Oh,
St. John.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
First day of the week cometh Mary Magdalene early, and yet when it was dark, unto the sepulchre, and seeing the stone taken away from the sepulchre. Then she runneth and cometh to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and saith unto them, They have taken away the Lord out of the sepulchre, and we know not where they have laid him. Peter therefore went forth, that other disciple, and came unto the sepulchre. So they both together ran, and the other disciple did outrun Peter, and came first to the sepulchre. And he, stooping down and looking in, saw the linen clothes lying, yet went not he in. Then cometh Simon Peter following him, and went into the sepulchre, and seeing the linen clothes lies, and the napkin that was about his head, not lying with the linen clothes, but wrapped together in a place by he itself. Then went in also the other disciple, which came first to the sepulchre. He saw and believed, for as yet they knew not the scripture that he must rise again from the dead. Then disciples went away again unto their own home. Thus far the gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
They may be purchased for $5 each after the service. If you want, just come on up and take them. And you can need $5, you know, to the stuff. There's a basket out there on the literature table. Just go ahead and take those. You can leave $5 in there. Join us for morning prayer and Holy Communion tomorrow and Tuesday, for Monday and Tuesday in Easter week, Prayer of Holy Days here at the church. Refreshments after the service today are provided by Beth Dixon. And Beth will be offering yoga classes very soon here at the church, beginning about next week. Beth sent out a schedule.
This week,
I didn't get to look at it because I've been
Tuesday
too busy.
Evening.
So go ahead and tell us all about it, Beth. What days are we, what are we doing here?
I don't have a schedule right in front of me, but I sent it out by email. I posted it on the Facebook page, so the monitor will have to put that out there.
What day? So we're meeting on Tuesday?
Tuesday evening.
What time?
Present it to 6:30.
6:30 here at the church.
Because of the services, Monday, Tuesday morning, we might have a conflict with that. So it's two times this week and Saturday, so just look at the schedule.
Okay, so we will get the Facebook moderators to put that on. Approve the comment, can you?
I would like to have that in an email so that I know what I'm writing about.
Okay. Awesome, thank you. So Tuesday at 6:30 and Saturday when?
I don't
know. Okay. All right.
I just have to look at my phone. My phone is in my phone.
All right.
So Saturday, Beth, it's at 10 a.m.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay. Awesome.
Thank you. And you guys want
okay, the next regular meeting of the St. Walburga chapter of Daughters of the King is 9 a.m. Sunday, April 26th here at the church. Blessings disguised as trials. Once a month we have our grace grid and thanksgiving prayer and fellowship group here at the church. It's the last Tuesday of every month. We meet at 6:30 and we have a topic that we discuss. This month the topic is blessings disguised as trials. We will look at God's faithfulness through the trials in our lives. Join us from 6:30 to 8 here at the church, Tuesday the 28th. Light refreshments will be served. Amanda Hitch Catwalk is coming up. Team St. Albans is back for the fifth year in a row. We have supported this walk. This is to raise money for Cancer Life Net here out of Upper Chesapeake Hospital. Over the years, we've raised $10,000 to support this organization, this ministry, if you will, which ministers to people battling cancer and their families and friends and loved ones. And where are we with our goal, Christy?
As of the last check, it was $1,965. So thank you for all the wonderful support. We also have a returning sponsor, Uncle Smine Grinds, the restaurant here in Boston, is going to give us a share of proceeds on May 7th in the afternoon, and that's a Saturday. So that's really something special. So we'll get more information about that in the bulletin.
Wonderful. You can put a donation in the offering plate, you can give online, and get that in, that'd be great. Now don't forget about, this is the last Sunday we will collect for our Bishop's Lenten Appeal. The diocese is trying to raise $100,000 to build 5 churches in the Philippines and Haiti. They're asking each individual to give $1.50 a day for the 40 days of Lent. That's about $60 a person, or more as the Lord needs you. So you can get that, put that in the offering plate, put Lenten Appeal on your check, you can give with a kiosk out there, or you can give online. Just make sure you designate what it's for. On the kiosk, you can write on the receipt, Lenten Appeal. When you give online, you can like type in what it's for. So I think that is it as far as announcements go. Are there any other announcements, anyone? Any birthdays that I missed or anniversaries? Okay. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
This morning I have for us a letter from our bishop. It is the presiding bishop's Easter message, 2022. Bishop Chad Jones was once the rector of this parish, so he ascended to the lofty heights as the presiding bishop of the Anglican Province of America. So he's a good friend to all of us and a great guy. So I'm going to read his message to the diocese today. Alleluia, Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. As St. Gregory Nazianzus, the great theologian of the 4th century, proclaims, with us, Easter is the feast of feasts and the celebration of celebrations. It excels all other festivals, as the sun excels the stars. And this is true not only of human and earthly feasts, but also of those belonging to Christ and celebrated for Christ. The solemnity of Easter, the third day resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ from the dead, is the queen of all feasts, the heart and center of the Christian year, the focal point of all life and truth, and of all history. On Easter Day, Jesus rises alive, deathless, immortal, full of glory, radiant with the life of the Holy Spirit. In Christ's physical bodily resurrection from the dead, we celebrate the eighth day, whereon God in human flesh, now glorified and transfigured in our human nature, has recreated the universe and has brought the cosmos to its fulfillment. On the seventh day of creation, we read in Genesis that God rested from his loving work in fashioning the visible creation. On this Easter day, the eighth day, the day of resurrection, God has unleashed a new creation. For Jesus Christ is the new Adam, the Lord from heaven, the new man and the new reality, who sums up all things in himself and makes all things new. In the person of Jesus, raised from death by the Holy Spirit, God the Father has regenerated the world to share in the very life and communion of the Holy Trinity. Easter, this greatest of all feasts of the Church, is singled out amongst other feasts as the highest manifestation of Christ's almighty power as God the Son made man. It is the confirmation of our faith and the promise, pledge, and hope of our own resurrection from the dead. The mystery of Christ's resurrection was prophesied in the Old Testament, prefigured by the prophet Jonah, among others, who after 3 days came out of the belly of the fish. Jesus speaks of this in the New Testament, in the Gospels, alluding to his death and resurrection, and he talks about Jonah. He says, an evil and adulterous generation asks for a sign, and no sign will be given except the sign of the prophet Jonah. For as Jonah was 3 days and 3 nights in the whale's belly, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and 3 nights in the heart of the earth. Matthew 12:40. This fulfillment by Christ is described in the New Testament as a historical fact with the appearance of the angel to the women bringing the spices to the Holy Sepulchre, which image was the first used in Christian iconography. Later, the early Christians depicted the resurrection in iconographic form as the descent of our Lord to the dead, the harrowing of hell, which we read about in 1 Peter 3:18-22. Christ's resurrection, witnessed by St. Mary Magdalene and the holy apostles, took place on a Sunday morning after the Sabbath, early on the first day of the week. From that day all the way down to today, every Sunday is a little Easter. Every Sunday symbolizes the beginning of new life, which shone forth from the grave on that first Easter day. Our celebration of Easter is not only a commemoration of a historical fact and event, it is the beginning and the foretaste of the future eternal life of the renewed creature and a renewed creation. As the first day of creation in Genesis was the beginning of days calculated in human time, So on this day, the day of resurrection, is the beginning of days outside of time, the initiation of the mystery of the fullness of life, of the future life, the age of the world to come, the kingdom of God, where God shall be all in all. Jesus Christ was born. We are born also in this world. Jesus Christ died, and we too shall die, how and when it shall please God. Jesus Christ is risen from the dead, raised to newness of life by the glory of the Father, and we too shall rise at the consummation of all things and live. Live with Jesus, live in Jesus, live for Jesus forever. St. Paul the Apostle writes, "If Christ be not risen, then our preaching is vain, and your faith is also vain. And if Christ be not raised, your faith is vain, ye are yet in your sins. If in this life only we have hope in Christ, we are of all men most miserable. But now is Christ risen from the dead, and become the first fruits of them that slept. For since by man came death, by man came also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive. If the spirit of him that raised Jesus from the dead dwell in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his spirit that dwelleth in you." That is St. Paul the Apostle from 1 Corinthians 15, 14 through 22, and Romans 8, 11. Let us meditate on this love of God revealed to us by the preaching of the gospel, especially as we approach the holy altar and receive in our Easter communion that same glorified body, blood, soul, and divinity of Christus Victor, our risen, mighty, conquering King, by which he destroyed death and grants us everlasting life. May Christ, our true God, risen from the dead, bless you and all you love as we celebrate his victory over sin, Satan, and death this jubilant Eastertide. Signed, the Most Reverend Chandler Holder Jones, Presiding Bishop, Anglican Province of America. And may the Lord bless each and every one of you this Eastertide and always. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The earth trembled and was still when God arose to judgment. Alleluia. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. We offer the Holy Eucharist to the praise, honor, and glory of God for all of those on our parish prayer list, those whom we mention in the secrecy of our hearts, and for all the faithful departed in Christ. Rest eternal, grant unto them, O Lord,
and let thy perpetual shine upon them.
May the souls of the faithful departed through the mercies of God rest in peace.
Amen.
Pray, brethren, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord receive this sacrifice at our hands to the praise and glory of his name, both for our benefit and that of all his holy church. Amen.
Receive, we beseech thee, O Lord, the prayers of thy people, together with the offering of this sacrifice, that what is begun in the paschal mysteries may, through the operation of thy grace, avail us for a healing remedy unto life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's Church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people, give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our holy mediator and advocate.
Amen.
Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession to Almighty God, devoutly kneeling. Almighty God,
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ saith unto all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul saith. This is a true saying, and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that, by the merit and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. Here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we, and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion, may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy, through our manifold sins, to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee. O Father, almighty world without end. Amen. Let us pray. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven,
worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through with his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen.
Thank you.
Therefore, let us keep the feast with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God,
we most kindly thank thee for thou hast vouchsafed to us, who have duly received these holy mysteries, with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom, by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen.
O Lord God Almighty, whose blessed Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, did on the third day rise triumphant over death, raise us, we beseech thee, from the death of sin unto the life of righteousness, that we may seek those things which are above, where he sitteth on thy right hand in glory. And this we beg for the sake of the same thy Son, Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us bless the Lord. Depart in peace. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be
to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.